The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, which is the first of all his commandments? Jesus replied, the first is this, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. The scribe said to him, well said, teacher, you are right in saying, he is one and there is no other than he. And to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself, is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. And when Jesus saw that, he answered with understanding. He said to him, you are not far from the kingdom of God, and no one dared to ask him any more questions. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's gospel passage, we hear the two new commandments, the greatest commandments that Jesus gives us by loving God and loving our neighbor. And it's important for us to observe that because he is telling us how to go about doing that. First of all, we must always remember that the only way that we can truly love God and others is by first being open to receiving the love of God ourselves. We need to let him love us and fill us with his love and with his Holy Spirit so that we have love to give unto others. And then, through that love, he is telling us to love God with all your heart, with all your soul, all your mind, all of your strength. Therefore, it's important for us to always meditate and contemplate on where we stand in these categories of our life. So, for example, he is telling us to love God with all of our heart. So we must ask his heart, we're not talking about our physical heart, but our spiritual heart here, where we are, is our heart filled with love, or have we let it get away with having bitterness and resentments and unforgiveness and pettiness and basically acting unloving unto others, basically being selfish. Because if we are, then we're not going to be able to love him as much as if it was filled with his love. Our soul, which is our spirit, is in a state of grace. Are we receiving the grace of the Holy Spirit in the sacraments so that our soul is alive and shining to love God with all of our soul, the soul that is our, basically our mind and heart that is going to come with us when we finish our journey on this earth. Then our mind, that's an extremely important one, especially these days, because we want our mind to be always, of course, it's only suffering from mental health that does not make the person a bad person whatsoever. It's like any other disease. But when we are letting our mind, without having any real issues, go there because of our choices, then it's something that we must meditate. So if we all day long, as so many people do these days, are going through rabbit holes on the internet, going through conspiracy after conspiracy, and then we start seeing the world in a negative way because of what everything we're consuming, or comparing ourselves with others on social media, or basically the good old-fashioned ways of letting our mind and start being judgmental and being someone that is not thinking positive things about others, then our mind is not going to be in the right place to truly love God. We want our mind to be inspired for us to meditate on the gospel, on meditate on everything that is beautiful, to have a gratitude so that we can see the world through the lens of thanking God for everything and not what's wrong with the picture all the time. And then, of course, our strength. The more we love, like any muscle, the more we're going to be able to love. And we have to be willing, though, even though it hurts, to love heroically, to love sacrificially, to forgive when it's hard, to give when it's difficult, because then we are able to do so until it becomes second nature. And when we have all those categories with the grace of God in a good place, we are going to be able plug them in a better place. When we let them go, for some reason, we're going to be more limited. And then the other part is the second commandment, love your neighbor as yourself. So not only, of course, we first have to love God, let him love us, but then we have to love our neighbors. But then as yourself means that we also have a healthy way of loving ourselves, not in a vain, narcissistic way, but in the way that we see ourselves for who we are as sons and daughters of God. And the more we love God and let God love us, the more we will see ourselves that way, and the more we will be healed from all of the things that so many times not only can make us have self-hatred, but worse, it can make us basically so petty in our way of being and everything, that it truly is hard to love our neighbor, because basically we don't have enough energy, if we don't have enough, if we're thinking about ourselves the whole time in negative ways all day long, how are we going to step out of that and of that shell and really reach out to those who really need it, to those who are desperate? So loving ourselves is actually the most healthy way to see our lives, which is basically to see ourselves be loved by God, and through that we are instruments of his love. So this is the most serious commandment. It's what everything is made of. God is love. It's our eternity in heaven. The only thing we're going to take with us is love. That's it. So let's get it right, and let's ask the Holy Spirit to help us increase our love each day, so that we may truly follow these commandments in the way that we are invited to. And remember, God never tells us to do anything without him willing to help us to do it. He's not making this as a test that we have to pass on our own. He's giving us everything we need to be able to be filled with his love unto him, unto others, unto ourselves. God bless you.
God bless you. Amen.